You expired, Jesus, but the source of life gushed forth for souls, and the ocean of mercy opened up for the whole world. O fount of life, unfathomable divine mercy, envelop the whole world and empty yourself out upon us.
O blood and water which gushed forth from the heart of Jesus as a fount of mercy for us, I trust in you. O blood and water which gushed forth from the heart of Jesus as a fount of mercy for us, I trust in you. O blood and water which gushed forth from the heart of Jesus as a fount of mercy for us, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. O Christ, eternal sweetness, I'm most delighted when I see that you're loved, and that your praise and glory resound, especially the praise of your mercy. O Christ, to the last moment of my life, I will not stop glorifying your goodness and mercy. With every drop of my blood, with every beat of my heart, I glorify your mercy. May your mercies, O Lord, be glorified now and for all ages. Amen. Dear beloved of Christ, I welcome you to our today's meditation on St. Faustina's Diary, The Divine Mercy in My Soul, and today we read and listen in to diary number 1705. I read, after Holy Mass, I went out to the garden to make my meditation, since there were not yet any patients in the garden at that time. And so I felt at ease. As I was meditating on the blessings of God, my heart was burning with a love so strong that it seemed my breast would burst. Suddenly, Jesus stood there before me and said, "What are you doing here so early?" I answered, "I am thinking of you, of your mercy, of your goodness towards us." "And you, Jesus, what are you doing here?" I asked. "I have come out to meet you, to lavish new graces on you. I'm looking for souls who would like to receive my grace." "I am looking for souls who would like to receive my grace." Dear beloved of Christ, today we are invited to meditate on the power of gratitude. And in my culture, we have a very common proverb, and it goes, "The person who does not appreciate has no one to give unto them." As we come to the close of this year, I want to invite you to have this image of meditation, just to have time and meditate on the deep seated wisdom in this saying, "The person who does not appreciate does not get people to give unto him." It literally means there's no motivation to steer the people around him to give, because this person does not appreciate. I look at Saint Faustina. She's out early in the morning, meditating on the goodness of God, meditating on the many blessings God has lavished on her. And she says, "My heart was burning with love so strong that it seemed to me that my breast would burst." It's an invitation, my dear beloved of Christ, as we come to the close of this year. Take a moment with the God of your journey Invite him out. Take a walk. Take a seat at his feet. And together retrace back your footsteps, your path on this year. And you will be amazed of the great wonder of the God of your journey, of the God of my journey. His goodness, his mercy. I have no doubt that just like St. Faustina was bursting at the love, the goodness and mercy of Jesus and him, we shall have no difference. No matter what happened within the course of the year, no matter what challenges befell my life, befell my family, the Lord is there. And this moment, as I walk with him, he asks me not to focus my eyes on the challenges, on the dark spots of my past, on those storms that shook the foundations of my life, on the past. Rather, he asks me, he asks you, to walk back with him, focusing on him, as you replay the experience of your past. Would you love to take that journey with him? Yes, it is a choice for the brave. It is a choice for somebody who appreciates and delights his heart, that I'm able to recognize his goodness, his mercy, and I allow myself to be drowned into the oceans of his goodness for me. And while drowned, then I'm able to open up fully for his graces, for his mission for me, for the next journey, for the next step to take ahead. So, dear beloved of Christ, as we meditate on the deep-seated wisdom in this saying, as we take a walk with Jesus, replaying this year's experiences of each day, we are called to surrender our all. We surrender the journey ahead, we intercede for blessings, we implore his mercy, and so in gratitude for our past, we encounter our tomorrow with hope, with trust that the God of our journey is with us. And in our today's words of meditation, Jesus tells St. Faustina, I have come out to meet you, to lavish new graces on you. I am looking for souls who would like to receive my grace. It's at the close of the year, he desires us to recognize his goodness over the years. And he's out there looking for souls to lavish a lot of graces for the coming year. Would you love to dive into the mercies of God? With a heart filled with gratitude for the past, would you love to receive his graces for the coming year? To abandon ourselves to the oceans of his mercies and trust that with him we shall encounter each day with our head raised high as needs and drown in the incomprehensible goodness of having our God, our Creator, our Redeemer, our Savior, our all in all on our everyday's journey. May your mercy, O Lord, be glorified now and forever. Amen.